Hello everyone. Today we're going to do something a little different. Someone asked me to do a mod making tutorial, and a year or so after that request, I've just realized I want to change something in the game, so let's finally do that. Let's look at a little thing that annoys me, then go through how we'll fix it. A quick disclaimer, you can do this with just Sims 4 Studio, but I use two other smaller apps to help make things a little better to work with, and I'll explain why. All three programs are linked in the description. So I got into this today because I'm pretty much sick of emotion animations at this point. To demonstrate what I'm talking about, I turned them up so this sim will do them frequently. So we're talking about the mood-related idle animations that happen just about at any time when the sim is between actions, like between bites when eating. Sometimes it makes no sense, like, this cold ham and cheese is making me so hot. I must make noises so everyone around knows how arousing this sandwich is.
Karoo.
Emotion idle animations can start before you tell the sim to do something else, or they can start in between two things. I guess being in the middle of a long list of stuff that needs done counts as idle. Here's the part that I find annoying about this. Anytime a sim does an animation, it has to finish before they can do the next thing, so they don't do what they're told when they're told. These can happen once every couple hours, so they're pretty frequent. When you've played the game for 5 years, you've seen them hundreds or thousands of times. Doing some math, they can happen about 8 to 10 times per sim day. It's not a lot, but it adds up, and combined with simulation lag, it makes the game seem even more unresponsive at times. So let's look at how to fix that and the tools I'll use to do so. This will sort of teach you how to do entry-level modding. The game has a couple types of modding, XML and Python. The XML type of modding is not as powerful as Python, but it does let you make alterations to how things work. This is what we'll focus on here because anyone who knows Python doesn't need my help. First, we can use a program to get all the game's XML. The game's tuning, or really the settings for a lot of things like skills, are in XML. We're going to extract it from the game just to have a directory we can search inside. You can get the aptly named XML extractor for Sims 4 from Mod the Sims, made by Scumbumbo, who has been a big contributor to the modding community. Mine is already installed, but you put this in and run it, and you'll see something like this. You can see my settings here. You'll need to tell it where the Sims 4 is installed and where you want to put the files. These are pretty basic things, but something everyone with a computer should know how to do. At the bottom, I use the name only option so that I have an easy time later on. I'll show you why in a second. You can increase the number of threads if you have many CPU cores to speed things up. It takes my computer about 3.5 minutes to extract it all. It's a lot of files. As for why I use this instead of Sims 4 Studio, it's that name only thing. I want my files to look like this, and not like this. Also, it's handy to have something to browse and search. You can see that it makes it easier to browse files, and I don't want these long file names with 30 characters in them. So Sims 4 Studio is fantastic, but doesn't seem to have the option to make files like this. I put it all in a folder on my desktop, but not actually on my desktop. Don't do that unless you would like to have 70,000 files there. That would put my messy desktop to shame. It may take several minutes, but when it's done, you have a huge folder full of XML files that the devs have set up for us to modify. Now we can make our own searchable index of Sims 4 tuning files. We're going to have a Sims 4 mini Google thing going on here. This will let you do wildcard searches and browse around the game's files. I use DocFetcher for this. It's a great program, and it's been life-changing for me in the time that it's saved. Once it's installed, you can right-click in the search scope area, pick Build Index From, and select the folder you put the XML in. In the indexing options, if I add XML as plain text file type, I can use wildcard searches to look for all the things, like pull up everything about a particular career or skill and sort by the file name, path, or DocFetcher scoring system. It can kind of sort by relevance like Google based on file names and all that. It's super helpful in finding out how things work in game, but it's definitely just dipping your toes into the water as there's an entire other side to modding that involves Python, as I said. So once the index is built, we can search. Asterisks are wildcards, and I always do a search with one at the beginning and end. It's the only reliable way. Star Emotion Star brings up every instance of emotion, and that's far, far too many files. You can see it doesn't just look for the names, but also inside of them. Next, I looked for idle with asterisks to let it match anything around that word. This leads me to find the Emotion Idle Tuning file. This was definitely something Sense4 Studio could have done, but having the ability to search in files is a big deal. A lot of things are named fairly plainly like this. We didn't need to do tons of sleuthing here, but I assure you there will be many files involved in some mods, and it's handy to be able to search like this. Now to the last app we'll need, Sense4 Studio. You can download it from their site. My Windows Defender went off over this file in the past, and it did it again today, but it checks out. It's some kind of false positive, or I think the Sims community would have flipped their wigs already. Once installed, we can now open Sims4 Studio where we can actually make our little mod. Mine is already installed, but again, you may need to tell it where your Sims4 is located in your computer. It's probably in C program files if you didn't put it into a custom location. So once we have the game data loaded up in Sims4 Studio, we can use tools, extract tuning to bring up the window that lets you either extract or make a package file where your mod will go. We need that emotion idle file now. I can pick add to current package once I have it selected, and this will make a mod, for now we haven't changed anything. When saving this, you can actually put your mod right in your Sims4 mods folder and save it, reload the game, and save a lot of time doing that. The game has to be closed for the save button to work, but it helps a lot going back and forth to test things. When we open up Emotion Idle, we see that there are a few things in there. I'm a noob myself, but I played around with it. You are able to collapse the XML, and that is immensely helpful to understanding the structure of it. XML is a weird markup language with trees being heavily used to organize things. So we can see our two different tests here, as they're in different sections. The Emotion Idle is going to test if the sim has any of these super high or super low moods. You can see that it's a whitelist, so it's saying if this mood does exist, do this. If it were a blacklist, it would be saying never do this if these exist on the sim. So if the mood is on the sim, they'll play an animation every 90 to 120 minutes when the right random number is rolled. That's the lockout time. The regular strength emotions are a fallback to the main test here, and you can see it has a weight of 3. Increasing this would make the fallback happen more often. Setting it to 0 will make the fallback not work, but the game will still do its thing on the bigger emotions. There's a subaction I also set to 0, but it didn't work to stop the big emotions firing animations. Ultimately, I ended up setting that lockout time to a high number. I also set the weight to 0 in both places, and this way it covers all the bases. So I adjusted the weights to be 0 and set the lockout really high, and it seems to cover all the moods. It's sloppy, but it works. Someone in the comments will probably tell me a better way I could have done this, and I'd appreciate that actually. When you save the file wherever you saved it, you now have a .package file, which is one of the several types of mod file the Sim4 can read, but only when properly in the mods folder under Documents, Electronic Arts, The Sims4. Make sure mods are enabled in the game options, and when you load up the game, you should see your mod in the list. There's a good bit more to modding and loads of example tutorials out there. You're able to download tuning descriptions or TDesk files from Mod the Sims that have all the descriptions of code that developers wrote out for us. So you can sometimes understand what is going on in the XML. This can help immensely to making your own if you don't get what something does, but it can be hard to wrap your mind around. Sometimes the descriptions are a bit technical. This is helpful to understanding XML, and being knowledgeable about the game in general is handy to finding the right means of fixing something. You can kind of rely on context clues, as I did here. Mods get much bigger than this. This is puny. There are a lot of things you can do just by example. You can use other traits to help you make your own trait, and there are tutorials online for this. This is another area where DocFetcher comes in handy, as you may want to use a trait in a similar way to another, and finding the files where that trait is mentioned can be helpful. But yeah, if I can change something in this game, anyone can. I don't have much experience with XML, but now my sim doesn't act aroused while she's eating a ham sandwich. She just eats the damn sandwich. I doubt that I modified this in the correct way, if there is one. Sometimes I think you just do what works in modding. I'll put this up on my site for download with the link in case someone's interested in the final product here. Ultimately, a part of the journey in modding Sims 4 is to just make little alterations to things that bother you, and sometimes share them with others if you feel it's a decent idea. I know I'm probably not alone in being bored of my Sims constantly expressing emotions this way. They still show what mood they're in, but they're much less annoying to you as a player. If you learn to use DocFetcher in Sims 4 Studio, you can do a lot of really powerful things or simply tone down something you don't like as I have here. Take the time to like this video if you found it handy. It really does help, and thanks to my patrons as always, you're amazing. I'm actually going to be making credits an official expression of gratitude in my reward settings now that I am sure I can do it. Thank you all for watching and have a great week.